Hey detoxers, welcome back for the month of March. We are talking all about cell phone protection and cell phone safety from EMFs and radiation. So I'm gonna get straight into it. Today we are going to talk about what your cell phone company doesn't want you to know about their product. So straight off the bat, when you get that phone home, you open up the box, grab the phone out of it, and you instantly start to upload your contacts and all of your information onto the new phone. You take the charger out, you plug the phone, you start charging the battery of your phone so you can start using it immediately. And then you take that box and everything else that's in it and you just toss it away. But what we don't realize is there's a little booklet in there that none of us ever read. And every phone comes with this little booklet. And in there, in small fine print, it talks about safety ratings for your device. And every phone is required to have this. And each phone will have a different safety rating. But in there, it'll say how far away that device should be from your body at all times in order to use your device in the safest possible way. So let's talk about that, because every manufacturer is different and every model is different. Let's take the iPhone 7 for instance. If you have an iPhone 7, you need to keep that phone at least 5 millimeters from your body at all times in order to use the device safely. Let's take the Samsung Galaxy S6. That one needs to be at least 1.5 centimeters from your body at all times in order to use it safely. You need to go to a website, you need to Google it, find the safety rating for your phone and what distance it should be from your body to help give you information as to how to use your device efficiently and in the safest possible way. So this is a big realization, because cell phones are not safe to have on our body. And there are studies that have been showing that when you put a cell phone up to your head, it can actually penetrate into your brain up to 2 inches. So let's say you get a phone call and you're on the phone for 10, 15, 20, 30 minutes, even longer sometimes, and you have that phone pressed up against your head, that phone is transmitting frequencies that are powering into your brain up to 2 inches. And now 2 inches sounds like a lot, and it is a lot, but for kids, it increases exponentially. So it can go so much deeper in kids because their brains and their skulls aren't as thick. So it can actually transmit much deeper into a child's brain than it can an adult's brain, which is really scary. So kids using a device pressed up against their head or in their body is even more dangerous than it is for adults. And how do we combat this? Because I'm still gonna use my smartphone, and I know all of you are too. So the first thing is you want to use your phone on speakerphone instead of placing it up against your head. So instead of doing this, you at least can hold it further away from your body, and you can talk on the phone like this. Preferably, text is better because it's quick and it doesn't transmit near as much radiation when you're texting versus when you are on a phone call. Also, if you do need to carry your phone in your pocket or on your body, what you want to do is place that cell phone on airplane mode. And I talk about this in my video from last week, all about using your cell phone in your car. I talk about airplane mode. So make sure you take a look at that video as well if you haven't already. But using your phone on airplane mode stops the transmission of cell signal, of Wi-Fi signal, and of Bluetooth signal. So it makes it much safer for you to carry this device around with you when you have it and use it in airplane mode. So around your kids as well, if they use your device, having it on airplane mode is the safest way for your children to use your cell phone. Now, I've gotten a lot of private messages from people watching my videos about cell phone safety products. What is the best cell phone case to use? What's the best speaker system? What's asking all sorts of questions about products to reduce electromagnetic frequencies from your phone and radio frequencies as well. And to be honest, there are a lot of products out there that say that they help reduce EMFs. In reality, some of them actually increase the EMFs that come from your phone. So it makes it even more dangerous. So don't run out and buy a bunch of safety gear yet. I'm currently testing products for you guys so that I can tell you which ones actually do work. So hold tight, give me some time, and I will start to come up with a list of products. But I want to make sure I test them personally myself first before having you guys take a look at the products, because like I said, some of them can make your phone worse, and we don't want to do anything to make our cell phones even more dangerous. All of that being said, I hope you enjoyed this video. I'm going to include a link to subscribe to my channel if you found this video to be helpful. Also, like this video, share it with your loved ones, of course. This is such important information that it's important that you pass it along and share it with others. So I look forward to seeing you guys next week, and hope you have a good one.